I be trying to mess with certain settings. Settings. I was not talking in the mic. It's giving me crap. It's like, your bit rate's too high. I'm like, it's 6,027 and your recommended is 6,000, so chill. 5% off. Right? Or is that, that's 0.5%, something. Ooh, let's see how this is going to handle changing bitrate midstream here. Oh. fine. Perfectly well. Not an issue. I was about to click Stalker Clear Sky. Oh, I didn't even sign into Steam. Not even signed into Steam yet. Wait, what? Oh, wow. Okay, that was just... it sounded like that came, some noise came from my speakers, but it came from my headphones turned up way too high. But all good. Ka-thunk. Smells like a fire. I shouldn't be smelling a fire. My windows are closed. Thought I smelled a fire. Did smell a fire. You out of your mind. Is it really that OP? Jeez, man. Using my sniper button to adjust my audio ever so gingerly. Oh, yes. Weird bug, I need some kind of window behind Dangerous Waters or else it kind of floats around in OBS like a weird little willy-willy. Lue, lue. Oh, no. Zambanto. Ay, 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 lue, lue. I want this to always be on top. Embed chat and stream. No, I don't want that. Oh, no, I don't. Wait, I don't want you to see any of that either. Jeez, okay. Damn it. I have no repose. Hello, Mason Pfizer. Have I done any RA tutorials, Sergeant Sledgehammer? What do you mean? Like the weapons guide or something? Yeah, it's fine. In Dangerous Waters, you get to see more of my mug than in Cold Waters. You can see more of my beautiful face. Which Linky Link was Wuddy Wuddy? I don't know if it showed anything pertinent. Because I think the stream key is always kind of, it always has like the password stuff over it, I think. I don't think I even went to stream, went at exhibit, I don't know, whatever. I don't think it was. I think it was some kind of link for something. Yeah, no, this is all associated on the website, all the streams stuff and everything, so it shouldn't, you don't do it in here, you do it on the website, so I think it should be fine. I'm planning to make a weapons, RA weapons tutorial, actually. My patrons on Patreon voted for me to do weapons tutorial next, so that will be next. If you want to vote on those type of things, you can consider supporting me on Patreon as well. Hashtag shameless plug. Alrighty, so how do the Sonobuoys go? Uh-oh. I don't want to see that yet. That's cool, though, but I don't want to see it yet. Whoa, there's a way to make these for custom campaigns, man. Oh, that's cool. Okay, well, I don't want to see that yet. Homemade ciabatta. Oh, my goodness. Gotta put some nice butter on that. Or make a nice sandwich. Cheers. Oh, does it really? Nice. So I guess you got to be careful about the context there. Oh, I'm diseased. Not really. Sorry to hear about that, A-Ronk, but glad you're here. If my voice sounds a little different, it's because I was at the Renaissance Fair yesterday, and I was kind of screaming at the wrestling. They had a Shakespeare wrestling match, which was amazing, and I was enjoying it thoroughly. Oh, here we go. RGB, there's four, so no, okay. Very low frequency and medium frequency. Are they, I'm hoping they're listed here as if they were like Diecast, Diefar, and Vlad. Active mode. I don't know how these correspond. I wanted to look this up first, but time got away from me. 66 feet. 66 feet. Okay, so it looks like RGB. This one is the Vlad. This one is the Diefar. And this one's the Diecast. I'm going to write that down. I'm going to forget. RGB 75 Vlad. RGB 25 Diefar. RGB 55 Diecast. Hello, Red Lease. Oh, they're cap. Wait, what? Capitalized? Directional command activated Sonobuoy system. Directional frequency analysis and recording. Vertical line array directional frequency analysis and recording. 400 meters deepens. It was basically like some Shakespeare plays, but then superimposed on top of like WWF wrestling, so it was really fun. I think I got it right as well. Hopefully. I'm just basing it on the fact that these ones go really deep, like Vlad's. Whoa, wait, what? Oh, that's the deep. The deep goes to 400 meters. I was about to poop my pants there. Wait, deep? Shallow. Okay, 100 meters, yeah. Okay, that's about... It's a little different, but yeah, it's about the same. Alrighty. I think we can go ahead and get her started here. Get her done. Soviet diesel missile sub. SSG, yes. Extremely hostile environment prevents the SSG is on the surface. Prevents the SSG being on the surface, I think is what that's supposed to mean. NMI. I approve. Take a photo of the emergency sub from a close distance. Drop off a container. Oh, okay. This is important to note. Use Sonobuoy bathymetry buoy Rus. BT probe equals container. This will probably be in the brief, but I just want to make sure. Bathymetry buoy Rus. Roose Bolton, for all you Game of Thrones fans. How about the finale last night? Well, nautical miles makes sense when you're talking about the ocean corresponding to latitude and longitude. I am not a spoiler divulger, but it was good. So yeah, that I'm glad you were on top of that, Mr. Cucho. So yeah, if you've seen it, all you can say is you either agree or disagree that it was awesome, and you can't say anything else. Alrighty. Soviet diesel missile sub crashed in the area of combat duty. I think this is going to be everything I just saw, but I guess I can read it again. The sub is in dire need of repair and availability of parts, but an extremely hostile environment prevents the SSG from being on the surface. SSG sub remains secretive and awaits your arrival. That looks like almost like an... That's a Juliet. It's a freaking Juliet right there, dude. Rescue ships are halfway there, but the arrival is still very long. Oh my, is that Comic Sans? Is that Comic Sans? The situation on board the sub was deteriorating with each passing hour. You're instructed to go to the area and deliver emergency repair kit. 30 nautical miles around this approximate position. A nautical mile is equivalent to 1 minute of latitude and then 1 minute of longitude at the equator. Or at least that's how it was originally derived, but now a nautical mile is exactly equal to like 1852 meters or something like that. Oh, that continued automatically. That's Comic Sans, man. Continuously control district of the accident, the area of the accident, with attempt to communicate with emergency sub, an emergency dire sub. High command not knowing how to perceive the situation of the Japanese self-defense forces. Highly likely that may be undertaken unfriendly actions in relation to our presence. This sounds really cool, man. This sounds fun. Yes. Photografia. Take a photo of the emergency SSG sub from a close distance, not more than at 1 NMI. Ooh, it's burning. I love these little intro things, dude. I need to figure out how to... That's cool that you can make custom ones of these. I need to do that then. Oh god, nuclear death bombs, jeez. Drop off the container as close as possible. Oh, that's cool. That's like a real photo. Or something. A rendering? Alright, poll. Straw poll. Real photo or a rendering? Part of me doesn't want to say real photo because of how these propellers are captured there. And then return to airbase Nikolaevka. Take of stuff debrief by return. Oh, that almost looks like New York, man, or something. It almost looks like upstate New York. Alrighty. Okay, so the Mei can't carry anything on the wings. Well, it looks like it has pylons out there. But these slots don't work. And then the Bombay is smaller than the P3. That's interesting. Well, I won't really need to worry about weapons. I just need to make sure I have... Oh, I'm getting like a freaking Charlie horse in my chest. What the hell? Okay, I'll just go with the default loadout for now, I think. Oh, no, now it says type. And the reference says RGB. Ooh, what is going on? I think I might need some water. Oh, and the reels have it. I mean, part of me wanted to say it was a frickin'... Okay, everyone shield your eyes. I'm not sure if truth is on. I don't think it is. It smells like someone's having a fire. I shouldn't smell that. Oh, God, I forget that it has that stupid noise. Okay, we're good. District accident. You couldn't at least draw a little circle on the map for me there? Alright, well, give me some altitude.
Changing altitude. Three,
oh, well, this is interesting. This nine, seems really cool. Nine. I love playing off the Russia-Japan dynamic. That's a really cool dynamic to play off of. Because I'm so used to always having, like, you know, U.S. and Russia, but putting these different factions against each other is definitely very cool to do. So where is it? 4103, 138, 43. Let's see. No, I don't want that. I want to draw a circle. Draw a circle. 30 nautical miles. Is that what they said? 30 miles. 30 miles. As it gets bigger and bigger. 30 miles. Is that right? That seems... Wow. Yeah, okay. That's a really big search area. Well. And they said the sub's supposed to be being secretive. Am I supposed to find it with sonobos? Oh man, ETA is going to be a while on that front. Let's get up to a good cruising altitude here. I guess about, 8,000 meters seems pretty good.
Changing altitude, 7, 8, 2, 6.
Oh, we're kind of close to North Korea here. Yes, we are. Yes, indeedy. Because I'll quickly either do this or go to options. it's the trademark squinch to avoid spoilers. Dude, why am I smelling a fire? This is weird. Because I'm in an apartment building. There aren't any fireplaces in an apartment building. At least not in mine. Oh, you can see the mountain through the clouds. That's cool. You don't really get this high up usually. So it's just fun to see some of this stuff. Altitude. 1,000 meters, pretty respectable. This is decently hilly, rather hilly terrain here, and then you got some kind of plains. Interesting. I love that they made it a topographical map. That's really cool. And this is like an area where you could like sneak through right here, this really low plains here. Kind of sneak right through. Alrighty, well, we're definitely going to have to do some time lapse here.
Changing speed, 3, 5.
Because it's going to take forever, and we're not going to wait around for that, so let's go ahead and speed it up here. Oh, no. Ooh. I don't know if I've altered my... Yeah, let me check that real quick. You're not supposed to use 16 times speed in this game. It's buggy. But I may have already used some 16 times speed. Where is that? Shit, I have used some 16 times speed. Alright, 8 is the max. I'll just have to be cognizant of that. 8 times, there you go. External vodka tanks, jeez. Yeah. Seems this, I really don't know much about it, but it always seems a kind of thing of like, just get it done. I don't know. Differences in culture. I wonder if a more Western ideal of individualism plays more into individual worker safety versus more of a communal kind of societal mentality. Screen's messed up? Yes, it is. Thank you for reminding me. Oh, why am I sitting out here? Dude, sitting here with this amazing sound. How are the levels on this? It looks like it's pretty decent. But, oh, this sounds so good inside of here, man. And then it sounds like... Why can't you just, like... Why is this still not work? You have this cool, badass interior sound, but not a good exterior one. Just give me the P3 at least. I'm fine with just the P3. Just something besides... And it's really a bug of this game that they don't draw, like, country borders on these maps. I know with the Polish guys, they do that in their multiplayer maps, and that's very nice to have, to be able to see those borders on here. I do have a real bear cockpit now. If you watched my changelog video, you would know that. Glad to hear it, Callie. How's it going? ETA to target. 27 minutes divided by 8. Gives you about 3.5 minutes there. Sweet. Time lapse is amazing. There's no reason to simulate this extended time. Well, let me make sure that all necessary sensors are engaged.
EW contact bearing 2.
Make sure
I'm
keeping
three.
Filthy Krylov.
1003.
What is this over here? P3 Orion. Japanese P3. That is very interesting. Why have you not marked it, ESM?
New EW contact bearing 125. Assigned track number.
Just make sure that's.
There's no downside
to having that on, so just make sure it's always on. I thought I heard like a goal complete. But nope, just imagining things. P3 Orion with a rather strong. Oh my god, look at that subcommand model. Wait, you couldn't give all the AI models freaking like the amazing one? That is terrible. Plus markers? Oh, yes, okay. Yeah, so if I were to do. Then yeah, you get an approximate coastline. But yes, you have to make those sound effects when you are demarcating a coastline with marks. Alright, don't know if my autocrew is updating this properly. Bearing 126. Gamma turret extended.
Gamma turret extended.
Nice, as well as the Americansi. Normal. LLTV. Okay, good. They're emulating the fact that this is an older plane. They're not showing the infrared or whatever. 126. True bearing. Azimuth. And get it down. Well, if I don't have the heat seeking, it's going to be kind of hard to see this, but it's probably down there somewhere beneath the cloud cover. He haven't the clue. We will be radio quiet on this mission, but radio quiet. That guy's emitting radar, but we will remain radio quiet. What is this thing? Fotiv Krylov? ATF class? It has a igloo. What is this thing? A spy boat? Oh, is it like a minesweeper or something? All right. Oh, it's a towed sonar array boat or something like that, it looks like. Just drags around a towed. Wow, look at that photo. There's a Perry right there. There's a Tycon. That's getting pretty close to some freaking American stuff. That's interesting. What is the background of this photo? Yeah, good old SSN. I've heard you're more supposed to interpret it as a series of possible scenarios. They're not necessarily chronological or happen one after another, but just like how some potential scenarios would go down. I haven't read, that was the first Clancy book I ever read. That was back in middle school. I haven't read it since. Kind of reluctant to want to read it again because his other books like Cardinal of the Kremlin and Executive Orders and Clear and Present Danger are just like such good books. And SSN is not one of those books. Where was this bad? Okay, he's actually pretty far. Or moving kind of parallel to me or something. But he actually seems to be pretty far. Oh, what am I doing? Keep up the time lapse, dude. Keep up the time lapse. I guess we can watch how this goes along here. The bearing is not really changing too much. But it's a pretty strong, it's a pretty decently strong signal. 3 out of 5. It's pretty decently strong. Yeah, that's a good way to put it. I don't know why my autocrew isn't auto-marking these contacts, though. I don't know. Why not? It may be somehow a consequence of accidentally using 16 times speed here. But yeah, if you guys have not seen that, the RA guys mentioned it. Change your maximum time lapse speed to 8 times because it gets buggy with 16 times. Whoa. What the hell's going on? Damage. 5 minutes. What the hell is this? Is this supposed to happen? My fuel's already like less than half. What the hell is going on? I'm so confused. Hey, Kyle. What, losing engines is a bug, or being already like freaking at bingo fuel is a bug? Because I'm at bingo fuel, man. I pretty much have to turn around. A Japanese stealth laser. Yeah, it's like from freaking, that was an executive orders, wasn't it? They're freaking super uber AWACS that can detect F-22s or whatever. Yeah, or that. So what is... Was this... I mean, I'm assuming it was full at the beginning. I wouldn't expect it to already be down to here now. Otherwise, I don't think I would be... That would be some pretty crappy range. I've gone what? Not even 200 miles? At, like, cruising altitude? Descend to get him back? Alrighty.
Changing altitude.
Three, God, that's eight, fucking... Those six. Negative dives, man, just freaking, they're crazy, dude. Maybe it went down to that fuel because the engines were freaking derping out.
Changing speed, 228 knots. Changing altitude, 1082.
Okay. We're all green across the board, but the fuel is still low. I mean, I had the impression that 3 was supposed to be, like, cruising speed and not frickin', you know...
EW contact bearing 1-8
full
zero.
Stops.
Sign track number 1-0-0-5.
I don't even know if that fuel...
EW
that,
contact bearing 1-2.
Yeah, it's moving
three.
All right.
Sign track number 1-0-0-6.
So should I restart here? I don't want to freaking... I don't want to run out of fuel. I thought I'd be good at 3 with the fuel consumption, but... It's not illuminated, but I'm already at less than half fuel, and I'm not even to the patrol area yet. I would consider that to be bingo fuel. Is that pretty high for turboprop? I don't know what cruising altitude is for turboprops. I just know the higher you go, the better your gas mileage, basically. Generally speaking. I'm gonna restart. I don't wanna frickin'... Because I have to return to base at the end of this. Oh yeah, I've never seen that happen in a P3, though. I think all this... I didn't adjust any of this stuff. Well, yeah, to a point. At a certain point, you just can't even gulp air anymore. So what do you guys recommend for cruising altitude? Maybe 3,000, 4,000 meters?
Changing altitude, 4,095.
Oh, I gotta draw this circle again. What was it? 4,103, 138, 44. Do-do-do-ba-do, 4,103, 138, 43. Yeah, plus or minus this, good enough. When your mark's off by just a little bit, but you have a 30 nautical mile search radius for, what is that, nine times. 900 times pi, 20, for like 3,000 square miles of search area, yeah. It's not a big deal. Okay. Yeah, get me over that way. I think we'll just like start off by doing a nice little... Frickin' line of sonobuoys down the frickin' diameter here. God, that's a big search area, man. That's a big search area. Let me see if this doesn't tell me what a good cruising altitude should be. Ceiling is 26 to 33,000 feet. Range is 3,500 nanometers. Speed 354 cruise. See? 354 cruise.
I don't know, man. Seems kind of weird, man. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, the reason you make jets is because you want faster planes. Kind of seems like they should be more efficient at higher speeds. Yeah, I don't assume it's too sophisticated there on that front. I'm just going to do like 265 knots, I think,
changing
probably
speed
here.
265 knots.
Let's see what they say for high altitude.
Changing altitude.
See, they put me up at the ceiling for that.
3-6 changing speed.
Well, no, I wanted altitude medium.
Changing altitude.
Okay, we'll do that.
4-8-9
speed. Yeah, I'm gonna do the 265 here for the speed or something like that.
Changing speed.
Yeah, fuel gauge is full. All right. It's weird that it should not have gotten that empty. Yeah, that's like the future. Is that a simulator game where you have like every kind of like complex naval, aerial, and ground simulations all in the same game? Be nuts. I'm surprised they haven't made the PA playable yet. I feel like you could just start with a P3. Like, just make it a P3. Okay, 8 times 8. Let's check out what this fuel consumption is doing here. Maybe it's still using like the P3 fuel consumption tables, and it seems like this thing goes faster than a P3. So maybe it was thinking I wasn't like a P3 at the full stops or something like that. So I guess there's wind. No, there's no windage. I thought I had wind turned on. I don't know if I can. I can't. Oh, it's not on. I can't turn it on at this point. I like having that stuff on. But yeah, how's this fuel consumption doing? It seems to be, well, it's hard to tell at this point. 55 minutes divided by 8. Talking about 6 or 7 minutes. Okay, that's not too bad. I'll just power through here. My ESM, I don't have autocrew on, but autocrew doesn't even seem to be doing anything. It's not detecting crap. Dude, there's a dude right there. Freaking pick it up, man.
New EW contact bearing 153. Assigned track number 1003. New EW contact.
Interesting. I don't remember seeing this Nustro Shimmy before.
Assigned track number 1004.
Hello, Ixa. The PA doesn't have MAD. Oh, say what's going on in Discord? Yeah, I gotcha.
New EW contact bearing 116.
I'll say right now. I'll do it right now. I don't give a crap. Danger Towers IL-38 May campaign. Alrighty.
Engine 3 lost. Engine 2 lost.
Dude, what? Oh my god, I'm already at... What is going on with this? Why does this always happen with this... I'm about to say some mean things. About to say some mean things. Mamma mia. Here we go again. Let's picking up that P3 for a little bit. I don't know, man. This is really annoying. Doesn't make any sense. I don't know what's going on with this crap. Oh, hello, Hetty. Okay. Yeah, okay. I remember now. It's been a while since I've seen your name in the stream, though. Okay, yeah, I don't know what happened there. My mic just took a dump, but we're good now. I was trying to, like, unplug it and replug it in and cycle it. Dude, I just want to play this mission. I don't know what's going on, man. I forget you can go into this kind of view. I restarted the stream because my mic wasn't working. I don't know what to do. I want to play this mission, but it's killing all my fuel. And my engines are pooping out and stuff. Like, the sensors here aren't... I don't know if something's, like, overloading. Overheating. I don't know, dude. I don't know. And now it's like the speed's going through the frickin' stops. Three, five, whoa, not that. One
knots. Changing speed. 2, 2, 8 knots.
I really want to play this, but it's bugging out like a mofo, man. And I can't play it. I want to play it, but it's bugging out. You know what I could do? I could switch this to a... Oh, yeah, that wouldn't be that simple. I was going to say, I can just switch this to a P3 and play it real quick, but it would be more complicated than that. Or at least it would take longer than just going in and switching it. God damn it, dude. This is what half the time keeps me from recording Dangerous Waters, because I want to do something like this that's supposedly on the cutting edge, and it can't frickin' work. And I get frustrated, and I don't want to do it. Because as good as RA is, it definitely introduces more bugs than it fixes. It's not like other AAA games I can play where I know, like, if I want to play it, I can put in X amount of time and get a video. There's so much finagling going on with Dangerous Waters and crap. And poor bug testing and shit. They should do freaking, like, beta releases like the Cold Waters team does, the RA team. They should freaking do beta releases and have people play test this crap. Because I don't expect two or four people to find all the bugs in the world. But beta releases would be nice if people could find the bugs and stuff before you release a full version. I want to do this. I want to, but the frickin' maybe I just don't. Maybe I'm just not supposed to go high. Maybe I'm just not supposed to go high. Going high is my problem. Going too high. Just need to stay down here, which goes against my conventional wisdom, but... Oh, that's a fun bug. Because it seems like the fuel consumption down here is frickin'... cheery. You know what? Let's try that. We're gonna try this one more damn time. I tell you what. We're going to try this one more time. We're going to stay low. Stay low. We're going to go to 600 meters, 265 knots. Now we're going to stay like 245 knots.
Changing speed, 265 knots. Changing speed, 245 knots.
And we're going to freaking head over here. We're going to stay down here against all my conventional wisdom. 41.3, 138, 43. Drawing tools, add area circle. To 30 nautical miles. And then do that. Maybe I should have reset the game with a frickin'... Well, maybe the time-lapse thing is actually... I can reset that on the fly. But yeah, do that. Just... It's almost not enough altitude to clear the frickin' hills in this... Near this base. And we're gonna be coming in close to the dirt there, man. Woo! Hey, Leoberto, how's it going? I think it was. I don't know. But we'll stay down here. Contrary to all I know about airplanes, we will stay down here. And we will cruise up to our point. 63 minutes. That's 8 minutes sped up. This will take a little bit. But we'll do this. We must get Moose and Squirrel. Hello, Jaeger-Panzer, but I want to say Jaeger-Panzer. Jaeger-Panzer? Jaeger-Panzer. Not Jaeger, sorry. I'm half expecting someone to make a Jaeger-Panzer now. What would that be? A bottle of Jaeger in the shape of a panzer? I don't know. I'm gonna grab some water. That is cool. Something from like from Air Regiment. Take of stuff debrief. Ugh. Okay, so our fuel consumption is what I was expecting now. Okay, so we are good in the hood on this front. This is working out well. Okay. Hello, Sawyer again. Hello. How many hours of flight time do I have? None. I've only flown planes in a video game. If all the engines crapped out while I was AFK, I'd come back and be like, what the hell happened? Wouldn't even know. Oh, the ESM is not
new
on.
EW contact bearing 129. Assigned track number 100.
Still seeing this P3. I was thinking this P3 was messing with me somehow, but it's not a bear. If you guys ever play against a P3 and there's a bear in the mission, they tend to go like rogue and start chasing you and shooting at you with their tail gunner. I actually had one shooting me and do some damage to me with his tail gunner.
Cookie.
That I say, let them eat cake. I don't know. It seems highly specific for a submarine in this day and age to make something with that goal in mind. Apparently, only that goal.
New EW contact bearing 165. Assigned track number 1004.
Fishing boat. Looks like this guy's out in this area, too, looking for this sub. This will be interesting. Alrighty, we are almost in the search area. Pool is cool. I think it was a saltwater pool, wasn't it? I mean, that makes the most sense. Ain't nobody got time to maintain a chlorine pool. But it also sounds kind of gross. Wait, where is this?
Engine 3 lost. Engine 2 lost.
Again with this. I thought I had the formula figured out. I don't know what's happening. I can't see what's going on here. Left side engine 1, right side engine 2. That's the outboard engines, isn't it? Or is it the inboard engines? It can't. I don't think it's scripted. It keeps happening at very different places. Whoa, hello. I'm like about to die.
Changing speed. 3, 5, 1.
Those of you about to die, we salute you. Oh my god. That does not look like a recoverable thing. I just want to play this campaign, dude. It looks like fun. But this buggy ass shit, man. I can't deal with it. Okay, they're both repaired. What's the holdup, man? Go. Do something.
5, 1 knots.
I don't get what's up with this instantaneous drop to half fuel. Like, what is this crap, man? Like, I don't know what's happening. I just want to play. All I want to do is play. I just want to play, dude. And I can't. This shit. No, I'm blaming this all squarely on RA. This does not happen in the P3. Or are you talking about that maneuver that looked like it was not recoverable from? Yes, that is DW. Sabotage? Who said anything about sabotage?
Oh.
after many long years, I have been gaming at the P3 speeds. And that mission, the one where I was in the Denmark Strait looking for a sub, I had no issues with flying at altitude or getting out to the patrol area in that one. But after many years, I finally have bought this. I don't know what took me so long to buy, but finally bought it. I don't know if you guys have ever seen like the Cinema Sins channel or the Cinema Wins channel, but I want to make one for this where it's like everything great about The Hunt for October. I want to make that video. I know it's kind of like copying this format, but I would call it like the fake everything great or something like that. Disc made in Mexico. I thought it said Iceland for a second. I thought I just heard a freaking Geiger counter. What the hell? I've not had it until now. I want to just go for it, but I'm already at like freaking bingo fuel, dude. I'm already at bingo fuel. Not a Cinema Sins version. Not a everything. There's already an everything wrong with Hunt for October. I want to make an everything great with Hunt for October. If you haven't seen Cinema Wins, check out that channel. It's pretty cool. Me being like, I don't know what to do, man, and boop, 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 boop. And me being like, ah, and the game being like, ha, and me being like, I'd be fine if I could just be out here and be searching, but they're like, no. I want to try one more time at like a lower speed. Ugh. It's like if the engines are overheating, fine, but I don't... Oh, I just got to the frickin' the thing as soon... Look at that lightning bolt. It's going crazy. Look at that lightning bolt. I wouldn't put it past Crazy Ivan, like... In that video where I said he's a sadist, I stand by that comment. He is a sadist. But look at that crazy lightning bolt. A seagull does know more about flying than I do. I'm going to try this one more gosh darn tootin' time. Or my sister's name is not Sue, which it's not because I don't have a sister. I'm going to keep it at 220 knots at 500 meters. And we're going to do this thing. 500 meters. 220 knots. Changing speed. Go that way.
220 knots.
Am I going to hit the ground? No, I think I'm fine. Nope, I'm good. It's close, but we're good. Okay, drawing tools. Add area circle. What are the coordinates again? 41, oath. What is that infernal racket? 4103, 138, 43. 4103, 138, 43. I don't know why they didn't just draw a circle on the map, man. It's silly. Freaking silly. Do that. Oh, why are you speeding up? Oh, why are you speeding up, mate? Don't be speeding up. I didn't tell you to speed up.
Changing speed.
I don't even know if 220 is really like a sustainable speed. I didn't tell you to speed up, mate. We're going to stay on this screen and watch the fuel because I want to know if it's a steady drop or a fuel dump. Turn off autopilot. Oh, and then I can manually adjust the throttle. Well, well. That's gonna make the speed drop, right? Yeah, there you go. Okay. Interesting. Is it gonna maintain altitude if I have autopilot off? Yeah, let's do this. Let's do this. The autopilot seems to be being kind of spoopy. We'll hold a 240 knots. And ETA is 8 minutes. No, it's going to be sooner than that because we're going here. ETA is 6 minutes. Cool. 6 minutes sped up, that is. I want to make one of these about K-19 as well. And even U-571 maybe. I don't know. This Blu-ray disc is manufactured to the highest quality available. It is possible this Blu-ray disc was manufactured after your Blu-ray disc player. Yes. My PS4 should not have a problem with that. It is a Sony technology. Changing speed randomly, yes. And they are proud of it. Yeah, I guess you still set speed manually even though the autopilot is off.
Changing altitude. Yeah. 5, 5, 4.
Okay. I think we should be good now. It seemed like it was pushing it to the stops a little too hard. We can speed up a little bit. It's not even really doing much. It's not doing anything, in fact. That range of throttle didn't do anything for my speed, which is interesting. Well, now it's starting to go up. What the hell? I probably should have just restarted the game so I could have gotten that windage going on. Well, I think you can refuel A-Rock, but you have to land at the base. I think you meant mid-air refueling. What is that right there? What is this? Are those mountains or is that like clouds? Like that? What is that? That doesn't make any sense. I wish this was the original movie poster, not this weird cover with airbrushed to shit Alec Baldwin face here. That even looks like it's painted. It doesn't even look like a photo. Okay, that autopilot is on, but autocrew is off. Okay. See you later, Hetty. Autocrew just does flares and stuff. I turn autopilot off. I don't want to turn autopilot off. Whoa, what the hell? What are you doing, boy? Slow down, slow down, slow down.
Changing speed. 2, 4.
Dude,
zero.
Dude, you're not slowing down, man. You're speeding up. Something happens at a speed in this game that the autopilot just wants to get to. It just wants to freaking get to that speed and just go ham. It's like, I need to do it, man. It's like a freaking relapsing druggie or something, man. Don't think into that too much. I'm just trying to make a my gear's not down, is it? Okay. It happens when I switch away from the pilot screen.
Changing speed. 2.
It goes crazy with the speed. That is interesting and annoying because I can't see where my ETA is. Need to soothe my ruffled feathers with another cookie. I don't know if you got how many of you are Americans or where Toll House is sold, but we made the recipe, my girlfriend and I, the recipe for Toll House cookies, and they come out greasy and almost mushy. It's kind of, it's a weird cookie recipe. They're like really flat. I don't know. They're still good, but they're not ideal, I guess. want the auto crew on in case someone shoots at me. I'm not a Scotch fan, actually. I like bourbon. Are you trying that right now, Emperor? Do you remember that from experience? It's not a problem in the P3, though. Tell you that much. American made. I think I have 240 ordered. Yeah. I got 240 order, but it keeps speeding up to 260. There's no wind either, so it's not like an airspeed, ground speed type of thing. Alright, where the hell are we? Balin was there. Alright, chill yourself. Chill yourself, son.
Changing speed to 4-1 knots.
But then when autocruise on, you can't adjust the throttle, but that's weird. That should be an autopilot thing, not an autocruise thing. Double Chasley is confusing. Oh, I can see the circle on this. Okay, that's fine. Oh, but when I start dropping sono buoys, it's going to start going crazy, man. Damn it, it's gonna frickin' freak out again.
Changing speed to 4-1 knots.
Dude, slow down. Frickin' wring your neck. So our fuel is good. I don't know what's happening. It seems like it's like an... It's almost like it's overheating, but there's nothing in here to let me know if something's overheating. It's not that sophisticated of a cockpit. Simple Planes the game? I don't know. Probably not. I enjoy airplanes, but I'm not very good at flying them. That's slowing down a lot more than one of the two. Okay. Overspeeding? Overspeeding is an issue too, but yeah, I was talking about overheating more being an issue. I mean, I guess if it's under the red line, then it shouldn't overheat. That's the point of a red line. Okay, so I want to be at like 160 meters here, or at most, I'll be at 100 meters.
Changing altitude, 104.
Alright, can I set my speed now and you're not going to freak out and go to 260
changing
knots?
Changing speed to 4-2 knots.
Can I drop sono buoys from here? I can drop sono... I'm just going to have to stay in the screen the whole time almost, I think.
Arrival goal complete. Continue with your mission.
Oh, спасибо, девушка. I don't know if she's really a devushka. I don't know if that's the right word to say there. Alright, well, let's, can I finally get some substance here instead of bullcrap problems? Sonobuoy, RGB 75. Well, first let's get this out. Freaking see what our layer's at here.
Buoy away.
Excuse me. What is the maximum depth of a Juliet? There's like two engines. Oh, I guess one of them's the diesel, one of them's the electric. Depth, 775 feet. Okay, what about our buoys and our layer? Our buoys, RGB 75, deep goes to that deep. Shallow goes to that deep. It's interesting, that's not particularly deep. Or shallow. Well, I guess that's better than the Vlad. The Vlad shallow is like 600 feet or something. Okay, I gotcha. Guess it depends where the layer is then. We will see that shortly. I have to say vigilant on this speed. This is annoying. Oh, don't you dare, Mr. Changing Hopkins.
Changing speed. 2, 4, 1 knots.
Container drop. I'm not dropping a container. I'm dropping a BT. I want to see the layers at, man.
Return to base. Roger out.
Mission out? What? What? I have stores. Wait, what? I have not dropped the container. Please don't tell me this mission is that buggy. Please don't tell me it's that buggy that I can't acknowledge when I'm trying to drop something close to the submarine versus not. Alright, whatever. Stay the 260 knots at this point, like I care. Yes, this is that mission. Well, at least we got frickin' 999 channels. Layers at 365 feet. Not sure where to expect this boat. It surfaced. I got the impression from the brief that it was submerged. Extremely hostile environment prevents the SSG is on the surface. I interpret the is as being on the surface. It remains secretive. A sub and being on the surface and being secretive are not one and the same in modern times. I know I need to drop the BT on top of it, but I feel like the mission logic would be like, if dropped BT and this close, then do that, and I'm not that close, so. Unless I got really lucky just then.
Camera turret extended.
New EW contact bearing 047.
Oh, I was wondering what the hell that noise was. It was a frickin'
003. EW contact
helicopter
bearing
flying
057. Assigned track number 1004.
I wanted to end about now, but this is not suitable to end with because this mission is being spoopy. How's this doing? Still hasn't freaked out. I feel like it's been going to half fuel once the engines dump out. As if to say, you know, that those fuel tanks are only meant for those engines. But I feel like you'd have the ability to reroute that. Okay, well, I'm not dropping buoys. I need to be dropping buoys. Drop buoys. Oh, 365 meters. That is deeper than the Juliet's max depth, isn't it? Because I was just conflating meters and feet there for a second. Juliet. Yeah, okay. So we're good with all shallow buoys here. It's going to be above this layer. Yeah, I got you on the speed. I just don't care at this point. That's true. I don't know. I mean, I need to go on the RA forums and be like, what the hell is going on with this crap? Because this is ridiculous. Ooh, flashy flash. I gotta wait for this sonar buoy to deploy. And this camera is not as good as the P3s because it doesn't have that frickin' amazing infrared. And the fact that I'm so low means I can't see as far, but besides the fact that it's just raining too. Camera turret extended. I was gonna say, is that the camera turret? But no, that's a running light. Something doesn't even really show up. I don't even know if it really has a camera turret. Buoy 2 is hot. Nope, there's biologics.
They're good mission designers.
Biologic. Alright, let's get another one out.
Let's get another one out there, tell us what time.
You need more coffee, what time is it? I am a slow metabolizer of coffee. If I have too much, it prevents me from sleeping at night.
New EW contact bearing 092, assigned track number 1005.
Fishing base mobile. There is a P3 in the vicinity. And all they give me is just like a freaking point of 3,000 square mile freaking location. I don't even know if I need to be dropping buoys or if I'm just supposed to fly around here until I, like, get some kind of communication or something. And then this one has the frickin' spaces between letters and the capitalization of the two and the, and it's, it burns. I don't have Russian voices installed.
Frequency alert, frequency alert, frequency alert, frequency alert, frequency alert, frequency alert.
Nothing. Nothing, Nathan, nada. Let's get another one.
Changing speed to 8 knots.
Buoy away.
Yeah, give me that 228, son. Give me that 228 patrol speed here. See ya. Hunt for October's only PG. See someone get shot in that movie. That's PG. Language is bad, little Timmy, but killing is fine. That's... I don't know if you're really political, so I'm gonna... Killing is fine. That's in the Bible. You can kill. But cursing is bad. I had to say it. It's just one of those things that really bugs me. And I only say it because I know that the MPAA is a somewhat conservative organization, a Christian conservative organization. Hey, hello. Established. It's like spelled exactly as you would say it with a Russian accent. Well, where is it? You tell me communications established. I don't know where the damn thing is. Oh, well, I don't have my link data on.
Incoming transmission.
Oh, well, that could be helpful. Oh, checkup. Okay. Well, we had a communication established. Big son of a bitch. No, it doesn't, apparently. Communication with SSG established. Where is it? I don't know where the SSG is. Oh, there it is. Hello. Okay. Dude, if I just had Link on this whole time, I would have been able to see it. Get your ass over there, dude. 1 mile. Hello, Ransom. This is, I don't know. I don't know anything about Silent Hunter to make a joke about that. All I've played of Silent Hunter is like the 10 Silent Hunter 4 videos on my channel, and that is it. It's just not my thing. Oh, I see you, fruit fly, on my wall over there. I see you, fruit fly.
Big son of a bitch.
7 minutes. Yeah, it looks like it's on the surface at 1 knot there. That's true. He does say goddamn. He does say goddamn. And then and then blows his brains out. Not really, but you get what I'm saying. I think ratings have evolved. I think they've gotten more conservative as time has gone on, though, instead of less conservative. Movie ratings, that is. I'm kind of showing this up, but I'm really just kind of, you know, looking at it. Did you know that The Hunt for October was directed by John McTiernan, who also did Predator? And that the Cobb wrote the screenplay for the movie. The guy who plays Cobb in Red October, he wrote the screenplay. Dude, I always thought the cook kind of looked like Ben Stiller, like a really agitated Ben Stiller. Am I the only one who thought that? At least in that scene where he's like, I'm about to cross the wire. He looks like Ben Stiller, I always thought. Let's get a little time lapse here. Try and help this travesty of time.
Seeing some explosions here and
whoa. What was that? Holy crap. Bearing is my course 265. I don't think I can see him from here, but they're getting explosions. All right, well, speed up, damn it. Like, I'm just like increasing lapse time, not even doing anything else. Guess we'll be seeing him on the horizon soon, probably within 5 miles or so. There's a pretty decent haze horizon going on there.
Assigned track 1006. New radar contact bearing 265.
New visual contact bearing 2.
I don't have mass detection radar on though.
1007.
That's weird. I guess they just... Oh, there you... Oh, wow. Hello. Okay. So dropping a supply container nearby is going to put this fire out. I gotcha. Oh, there's the visual contact going crazy. Crazy good. The Cochino. What did happen to the Cochino? Was it a battery explosion? Oh, the circle doesn't show up here. Range circles around contacts don't show, but area circles show up. All right, once we get right inside that thing, I'm dropping it. It's like from the Red Storm Rising campaign. Man, look at that sucker burn! Or holy cow, what an explosion! I can get it closer than a mile. I can get that damn thing closer than a mile. I tell you what now. Them boys need help. Drop now. Now. Now.
Good job! Uncle Sam's proud of you guys!
Bad, bad. Continue with your
mission. Return to base. Roger out.
Oh, it just says that every time we drop a container? Okay. That was funny. Funny. Alright, just want to check the old, good old, mission status there. Oh, didn't take the photo. That's right. Take that photo, son. Do it for your country. And, photo? 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 Photo?
New visual contact bearing 084.
Did that work?
Range 00.
Didn't work.
Assigned track.
Whatever.
Number 1.
I don't
zero,
care. It's fine. I don't feel like turning around to do it. B.
Return to base. Roger out.
Changing speed.
No, no, no.
3, 5,
not that.
1 knots.
Do this.
Changing
just,
speed.
Just do 245.
2,
something.
8 knots. Changing speed. 2, 4, 5 knots.
Let us RTB then. Do I have to be closer than 1 NMI for the photo as well?
EW contact bearing 302.
Just gotta go back to base now.
1, 0,
but I enjoyed
1,
the Uncle
0.
Sam line. That was good. Part of me wants to have another cookie, but part of me is like, no, you've had enough food tonight. I'm just singing nonsense. I spoke Russian, but don't think I know the words to that song. I just know how to stay kind of on tone to the lyrics of it.
Engine 4 lost.
No! Did anyone see what had happened there with everything going crazy? Was it slowly speeding up? I wish I could just rewind back in time to see what was going on with that. Hopefully at this point I can actually RTB. Oh, oh boy. Time to repair 5 minutes.
Changing speed. 3, 5, 1 knots.
Yeah, I think it's fine. That was supposed to be a Geiger counter, by the way. Maybe there's effects that I'm unaware of. Oh no, we're heading for the big drink. At a rate of like 2 meters a second. Actually, no, I don't think we are even. We're somehow climbing, but like aimed downwards. I don't know what's going on, dude. This plane is a travesty of crap.
Changing speed. 228 knots.
I say 228 doesn't even do it. He doesn't even do the 228. I mean, hello, what can I say? I mean, I think I accidentally got out of frickin' the pilot screen, so it's kind of my own damn fault it happened. those bastards. The cookies must go or I will eat more. The only way I could see the developers not seeing this bug is if they, like, never use the frickin' navigation map.
Two, assigned track number
potentially.
One,
like, that seems like a pretty common bug. That your engines just fail, and it seems like they can fail multiple times. I don't even know if I have quick repair on. I mean, the fact that they can be repaired in flight seems weird. That is weird. I don't have quick repair on. I don't know what's going on with that. Yeah, it's got a props convector. They're vectorable props.
Incoming transmission.
Another, the fishing base Alexander Ishkov is in distress in area blah. If enough fuel, come to the area and fold the raft container at the center of the damaged vessel. What? Drop a container? Where's this? 43. I'm writing this out. I can't. It's not multiplayer. 43, 53, 137, 20. Wait, what? Over here? 43, 53, 137, 20. Dude, that's so far away. I can't get there with the stupid engine problems and stuff, man. Can't do it, man. If I was in a P3, yeah, I could do it, but I can't do it, man. That thing is really far away, though. It's all the way over there. It's all the way over here. Juliet's here. What is that? Hostile. Oh, that's the P3. No
speed up. No speed up. Doggy afuera.
Okay. Well, we're RTB.
Roger out.
Oh, do I have to press it again? Is that what happened? Is that what needed to happen there? Needed to press it again? Dude, this is such a freaking debilitating bug. Shouldn't have to worry about this. Hello, Vlaxi. Yes, you are a little too late. At least in the sense that the mission is basically over. We've just been dealing with crappy May bugs, and we're RTB right now after finding a stranded Soviet diesel missile submarine and dropping supplies for it. They're pretty... Oh, well, thank you for telling me. Is the bear campaign any better? At least then maybe I won't have this infernal engine problem. Alrighty then, I may ditch this after this mission and go to the bear campaign. The rest of this is gonna be meh. I just don't want to deal with... did you get this bug at all, Monkey? Can anyone else be bothered to try and replicate this bug? Ooh, we're almost home. Almost home. That's a big hill. Hope I don't hit that hill. Oh, you did? Okay. Well, that makes me feel a little better. I don't want to hit the big impending hill.
Changing altitude.
So go higher.
6, 7, 1.
I have no plan to ever use nuclear weapons in this game, so that is not an issue. Go ahead and keep up with the RTB idea here.
Roger out.
Do they lower the gear by themselves? I don't think they do. I think I have to lower it. But I can at this point. And I don't want to do it with time lapse.
Mission is accomplished.
Hey, there you go.
Congratulations. Отличная работа.
There's a tree on the runway. There's a man on the wing. Okay, I got both of those. Interesting. Well, whatever. Alrighty. Alright, so thanks for watching, everyone. Been a alright stream. I hope it was more enjoyable for you. I was getting kind of frustrated there, but yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. See you guys next time. Might do another one this week. So yeah, see you guys then. Have a good one. As always, good hunting.